Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. We are still discussing kinematics of rotation and motion. As you remember in the previous video or previous example, we wrote the equation for the angular displacement or angular position. Is the angular position as a function of time. 2t squared plus 3t minus 4 and with the units radian. If you want to calculate the angular velocity, which is omega of t, you take the derivative, the time derivative. If you differentiate this equation here, I hope you know how to differentiate this. You bring this 2 down here. 2 times 2 will give me 4. This 2 minus 1 will be t. 2 minus 1 is 1, so t. Plus 3, you bring this 1 here down. 3 times 1 is 3. And then t to power 1 minus 1 will give you 0. T to power 0 is 1. And the constant will be 0. This is radian per second. This is the angular velocity of the particle, okay? You see, it depends on time. As you can see, the angular position increases with time. Then you can calculate the angular acceleration, which is the time derivative of the angular velocity, okay? The angular velocity. And this is will give you 4 radian per second squared. And we notice that this is a constant, okay? This is a constant for a special case, all right? This for this case here. So the general rule, I have to give you a rule here. If the power of the angular position, the power is 2, then your angular velocity will be a constant. If the power of the highest power in the angular position is 2, then your angular velocity will be constant. If the highest power in the time, the highest power is more than 2, let's say 3 or 4, then your angular position, velocity, angular acceleration will not be constant. Okay? This is a rule. If your theta, t here is 2 power 1, then alpha will be 0 in that case. So this is a general rule, and this is how you calculate the angular velocity and the angular acceleration if you are given the angular position. Now we do another example where it's the opposite, so, okay? So we are given alpha. So a new example here. And in this example, we are given alpha. And the equation of alpha of t is given by 5t cubed minus 4t. 5t cubed minus 40, and we notice that this is the alpha is not constant in this problem here. In this example, alpha was constant, 4 radian per second, but here alpha depends on time, okay? And this, the units of this is of course radian per second square. This is the angular acceleration. And he's asking, and he's giving you what we call the initial condition at t equal to 0, see? At t equal to 0, omega 0, we call it omega 0, is 5 radian per second. 5 radian per second. It means at t equal to 0, when you start the time, the object was already moving, rotating, and this is its angular velocity, and its angular position is 2 radian. It doesn't start from the origin, from theta 0 equal to 0, okay? It's at t equal to 0. The question is, calculate omega of t and theta of t. Now let me go back to the previous example. In the previous example, he's giving you theta and he's asking for omega and alpha. In this example, he's giving you alpha, he's asking for omega and theta. It's the opposite. And I hope you know, here we are differentiating to find the variables, and here we have to integrate to find the different variables, okay? So let's calculate, let's start with omega, okay? We know that alpha is d omega over dt. We can rewrite this, d omega is alpha dt. So I can integrate on both sides, okay, to get the omega, okay? So on this side, I get omega. On the other side, I have to put the alpha here. So I integrate 5t cubed dt minus 4 integral of t dt. This is how you write your omega. Okay? This is how you write omega. I'm putting alpha, the equation for alpha, the time dependence of alpha, I'm putting it here, and then I'm separating the two integrals, to make it clear for you. I hope you know how to integrate this. T cube will be T4 over 4, okay? T to power 4 over 4, and the T here will be T squared over 2 plus a certain constant. So this is omega of T, all right? The constant, you will get it from the initial conditions. The initial conditions, okay? So let's put a t equal to 0. We put t equal to 0 here, in this equation here. So this will be 0, and this will be 0. This is equal to c. But omega of 0, at t equal to, is 5, okay? So already we know that c is equal to 5. So I'm going to put here 5 for the value of c. So my omega of t for this problem, this specific example, is 5 over 4. T to the power 4, okay, minus 4 over 2 is 2, okay, minus what? Minus 2 T to power T squared plus the constant, which is 5, okay? So this is my omega of T. Now, again, if we are given theta and we want omega, we differentiate. If we are given alpha and we want omega, we have to integrate. And this is how you integrate to find omega of t. And this will be, of course, in radian per second. So if you want omega at t equal to 0, it will be 5. At t equal 1 second, you put t equal 1 second here to find the new omega. So omega is changing with time. Now, let's calculate theta of t. Okay? We're going to calculate theta. Okay? And we know that omega is d theta over dt. Okay? So let's rewrite this in a different way. D theta will be omega dt, right? So I integrate from both sides, okay, to find theta. So here, I get theta equal, I'm going to put this equation here, okay? So it will be 5 over 4 integral of t to power 4 dt minus the minus sign. 2 is a constant, we go out of the integration, t squared dt plus 5 integral of dt. Okay? So that's how you write your omega. You put it here inside the integral here, and you take the constant outside and you start integrating. So my theta of t becomes 5 over 4. What is the integral here? It's t 5 over 5, okay? T to the power 5 over 5 minus sign 2 integral of t squared is t cube over 3. T cube over 3 plus what integral of dt is t 5t plus a constant c prime, I call it. Okay, so there's a constant c here and there's another constant there, it's called c prime. So this 5 with this 5 will cancel, okay, and we get the theta of t. To find the constant, we have to use the initial conditions here, okay? So, theta of 0, like we did here, to find the constant c, we use the initial conditions for omega. We're going to use the initial conditions for theta. Theta of 0 is equal to what? You put 0 here, 0. You put 0 here, this is 0. And so this gives you c prime. And c prime is how much is it? It's 2, okay? 2. So c prime in this specific example is 2, okay? So my theta of t will be, in this case, 1 over 4 t to the power 5 minus 2 over 3 t cube plus 5t plus 2, the constant of integration, okay? So this is my theta of t. Theta is a function of time, and I have to put here in radian, this is an angular position, okay? If you put t equal to 0, you get 2. If you put t equal to 1, you have another position. If t equal to 2, you have another position, and so on. Since the variation of the position, angular position, is a function of time, this is how the angular velocity changes with time, and this is how the angular acceleration changes with time. Okay? Now, this is an interesting example where you have to integrate to find the variables, and the previous example you have to differentiate to find the variables. Thank you very much.